Well, a very good morning to all you panelists, and thank you for taking time out to be here with us this morning. So I'd like to begin the discussion with why commodities should be an important part of every retail investor's portfolio. Generally, the awareness seems to be less when you compare with another, with other asset classes, particularly equity. Equity is far more popular. But why is it that probably you should also be having a bit of commodities in your portfolio? I would like to start with you, Mr. Nagar.
Yeah. See, commodities is one of the, many of us think that commodities is a entered the market much later, and it's a new entrant into the online trading. Yes, online trading, it is a new entrant, but then if you really look at it, the first trading started with commodities. Historically, anything, whatever we started trading, it's a barter trade. It was not currency, it was not equity, it was not any other thing but commodities. So, trading commodity is in our blood. Most of us know what it is. But now, why it should be a part of everybody's portfolio? I would slightly differ on that, that I think over a period of time, one reason could be that the inflation, it could act as a good hedge against inflation. And for people who actually need the material, or who want to sell the material, or who want to buy the material, for them it's a different purpose. For the investor, it is a different purpose. For an investor, the prime expectation is it could act as a hedge against inflation, for example, gold. So that way, I would say that it should form a part of the portfolio of every investor to that extent.
Thank you. So, Mr. Rajesh, would you like to add to that, what Mr. Nagappan said?
Yeah, I see. Actually, as an investor, you should be expecting the returns in a safer way. So you should diversify your investments in equities or even commodities. So you should not leave the opportunity to earn. Suppose when market is not moving in equities, suppose commodity price are having a huge demand and supply. So if we know that this will get a good return, we should diversify our investments in both parameters.
Yeah, Mr. Sarvana Bhavan, what is the kind of response that you see? What's largely the kind of clientele that you have, and what is out of that, what portion constitute the retail investors?
See, actually, retail investors, they can invest in this market with the very minimum money. So that is an added advantage in this market. And you can see that market timings is more than almost 14 hours is there. So you can enter, whether if you are if you are working in some other company, you can use the part-time business as for commodities, entering into commodities.
Okay. And would you like to add to anything that Mr. Nagappan and Mr. Rajesh said?
Commodities, it's a very good asset class. See, if you are looking for equities market, it is totally based on the local domestic impacts is there, economic impacts is there. But in commodities, it is the international impacts. So whatever it's happened, China or US or whatever it is, you will get the data impact that will give you a more volatility.
Okay.
Can I add something?
Yeah, sure, please.
See, it always helps for somebody investing, like Rajesh rightly mentioned, it could be a very important point when you diversify your investments portfolio. But equally important is that somebody wants to invest in equity. It is essential that they have to know about commodities. They should have their skin in the game. And because most of the equity, the companies, the raw material or the input is, it is from commodity. So the prices of commodity, understanding the price movements of commodity internationally as well as domestically, it can help us a lot, particularly sectors like auto or sectors like pharma or agricultural, FMCG. These are the products which very much dependent on commodities, and it makes sense for even someone who is already in equity or who wants to enter equity to take an exposure to commodity and understand the dynamics of the price movements of commodity internationally as well as in India. To that extent, one is diversification, another is understanding the product is very, very important.
So, Mr. Muthappa, what is MCX doing kind of to push, make commodities investing more popular with retail investors?
Yeah, we conduct a lot of events, especially with IPF, and this is to ensure that you know, people know about the commodities before even buying or selling it. See, a lot of instances have been there wherein without knowing anything about that, they just believe in some of the these research calls, and you know, they try and enter into the market without any knowledge about that. and they tend to lose a lot of money, and then the blame comes over. So what we do is that we always tell that, take your time and know about that commodity, right? It is not about only buying and selling. You can invest in these markets also by taking part in deliveries. Now we have going to come up with multiple delivery centers. So you can always look at it as a hedging tool, right? So you can even look at, you can use options. So whenever you have a futures positions, we always say that you see, for example, if you are long on futures, you can always buy a put option to protect that particular price. And as I was telling in my presentation, we look at people to come and hedge in these markets. So cotton, as I told you, is a wonderful commodity wherein we have different stakeholders who are using these markets. So for a retail person or for a retail investors, we always tell that you, first of all, you see what is the risk reward ratio, whatever is involved in it, and you study about that particular commodity and then only get into these markets.
So we just spoke about why it should be part of a retail investor's portfolio. What about a producer, you know, who wants to use it largely for hedging? How important is hedging a part of his, to hedge his risks? What important role does this commodities investing play?
Actually, the gold markets, gold prices are going up and down on constant basis. So whether if you are a jeweler, then you should hedge your stocks, else you may lose. As Muthuppa has said, if you are doing it in forward markets, there is no guarantee on buyer and seller, the contract would be honored properly. But in MCX, you will get that facility. So 100% counterpart has to be settled by the exchange. So that facility is there. So every producer, they can take this opportunity to keep their losses less.
Okay. Mr. Nagappan, has hedging caught on with people in Chennai? What is the feel that you get?
To a larger extent, I think the market is yet to be explored, but then slowly it is picking up, I would say, particularly in cities like Coimbatore. The textile people have got into cotton. So I think people are slowly realizing the importance of hedging, basically because the extreme volatility which is happening off late in the last 10 or 15 years, if you look at it, this kind of volatility we have not seen in 80s or 90s. Very hardly we have come across, except in early 80s, we had the price of gold going up from $285, $300 to $800. After that, 20 years, gold never moved. I mean, it was coming down. But we see quite a lot of volatility, particularly, for example, if you take, of course, coal is not traded, but it went up to $112, now it is $78. 30%, 40% volatility within such a brief period, crude oil, it went up to 70 plus and then now it is below 40. So this is, and coupled with the fact that the dollar volatility. So people are realizing that the cost of hedging is nothing compared to the kind of the volatility which is, the kind of the risk they are taking by not covering their positions. So most of the companies I find that, they at least cover one third of it initially, then one third they keep the option open and they cover. So there's some sort of policy they are evolving, and many of them have started hedging. That's what I see in the corporate circles, yeah.
So Mr. Rajesh, what is the kind of margins that investors, so let's say an investor is starting off in commodities trading, the first question would be, what is the kind of capital that one needs to put? What are the kind of margins? So could you throw some light on that?
Before coming to margin, first thing, if I'm an investor, first I should choose which product I'm going to take. So if I'm familiar with the prices, I know about gold or silver. So first you understand the commodity price, how it fluctuates, what are the impacts about the price movements. Then you come to, if you're asking about margin, exchange is asking very less margin or sound. But I will suggest you could have at least 50% of the margin. First understand how the price is fluctuating. What is the impact on your portfolio when the price impacts are huge or volatility. Then you can know how the prices are and what is the impact about the profit and loss. Almost you should have 50% margin for keep us safe if you are fresh. So, but if you know, understand how the prices impact in a longer term, then you can have a save. As well as now many commodities, now we are integrated with options also. So better you can hedge with a future contract with the options to prevent huge volatility to occur many losses.
So that brings me to my next question. Mr. Saravanabhavan, there are like a range of commodities to choose from, right? The good part here is that compared to equities, the choices are still limited, where you have about hundreds of listed companies, whereas commodities are about a dozen or so. So when an investor decides to get into commodities investing, how does he decide on which commodity he should invest in?
Yeah, yeah. See, actually, as a member perspective, I'm telling, if he is a new investor, he should not go into bigger contracts. That is based on 1 kg gold or 5,000 kgs contracts. So he can. There is an option. In MCX, we have mega contracts, mini contracts. Even so, for 1 gram gold also, we need hardly 300 rupees is there for margin. 5% margin is required to take an option.
Mr. Nagappan, how does an investor choose on which commodity to start in? Would you advise that, you know, he can go in for more than 2 or 3, or should he just restrict himself to 1 or 2?
See, the choices are already very limited in commodities compared to stocks or other markets. So you have to be, even in that, you have to be very, very careful, because most of us don't understand the nature of many commodities. For example, we don't know why refined oil, soy oil goes up or comes down, unless otherwise we are an expert in it, or we have, you know, we've been tracking it very closely. We cannot understand the rubber prices unless whether we have a plantation or we are tracking it globally. So we have to understand the commodity first, basically, because the commodities, unlike equities, they don't have cash flow, they don't have any other revenue coming in. It is only the price which goes up or comes down based upon the demand. So it's a very different dynamics here. And then second part is that, even if you understand the commodity, you have to size it in such a way that you test the waters, start with smaller lot sizes like he was mentioning, like Saravana was mentioning, and then explore it and understand your risk-taking capacity, how your mind works when you take up a position, and then go to the next level. Now, the third question is that you asked that how many commodities you should concentrate on. Of course, we can always say that there is no limit on it, but then I think ideally it is better to restrict to 2 or 3 commodities. It's humanly impossible. If it is an individual, it's humanly impossible to track all the commodities. So restrict to 2 or 3 commodities where your core strengths are.
So Mr. Rajesh, Mr. Nagappan made an interesting point there on how you should restrict yourself to, you know, very limited number of commodities and understand them well enough. So what is it that you suggest to people who come to you to trade in commodities? How do they go about collecting information, knowledge? What is the kind of studies, background research that they should be doing before they get into commodities investing?
Before selecting this that commodity, either they have to understand what is the price impacts will impact, then what about the demand and supply? So what are the international dollar which will affect that? So better, if they are understanding the price impact, how it impacts in the commodity market, so they can select at least crude oil, gold, silver. So this price, how it is fixed in Indian market. So they came to know, then they can easily do.
Okay. Mr. Muthappa, what is MCX doing kind of to make life a little more easy for the producers who look at MCX largely as a hedging platform? What are the kind of products that you're planning to?
As I've told you that we are looking at now we gold is deliverable and we have silver which is deliverable among metals. So what we tell the producers is that trying to hedge on MCX is like to buy an insurance, right? So, and you know, if you don't buy insurance, what happens? Life becomes very difficult. So we just tell the producers that you come to an exchange wherein there is a definite counterparty for you to take your risk. Maybe the risk is taken by your speculator, right? So what we are trying to do, and especially for Indians, seeing is believing. We always want to see that particular commodity. We want to feel that particular commodity. So what, and this actually happens whenever we go to large corporates or even SMEs for that matter. In base metals, for example, if I go to a copper, winding industry, so they always feel that, okay, there are no deliveries, only speculation happens. But that is not true. The entire concept is getting changed. We have huge, corporates, we have Titan Industries, Tanishq Jewelers, they regularly hedge. We have Bima's, the jewelry the large jewelry chain, they also hedge on MCX. So we have numerous examples. So now what is happening is that one of the major reasons why the producers or the end manufacturers don't come in is that because they think it is an extra effort they have to track the markets. That is one important thing what we have been seeing. They're saying, sir, who will see the market still till 11:30 or 11:55? No, it is an extra effort that they have to take, and tracking becomes very, very important. And one of the major things, whatever we also say whenever we conduct seminars, is that if you come to an exchange to hedge, don't speculate. So what happens with the small dwellers or with the small producers is that actually they come to hedge and finally end up in speculating. So which is not at all healthy. So here, if you are a producer or a manufacturer, you use this market only for hedging. So by hedging, what you're trying to do, you are trying to transfer the risk, whatever risk is there in the spot market on that particular commodity, you transfer that risk, which will be taken up by a speculator. SEBI is clearly mandated us that even the base metal contracts have to be made deliverable. So we are working on that, and we are trying to develop a wonderful platform for options also, which could be hedge on futures. And we are trying to come up with some new products which we are looking at, which are basically experimented, and the research team is working on that, and we'll come with that very shortly.